Hi, I'm Johnny from Cinema 5D, and this is the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. This is a small event that Blackmagic designed, organized here in Manchester. Unfortunately, we are not permitted to shoot anything with the camera, just to see how it's operating. But for now, let's see what's new with the camera. Andy, this is the pre-launch event of the Pocket Cinema Camera 4K.
Yes.
Here in Manchester. A lot of people want to know, would this camera will arrive in time?
Yes, as per our NAB announcement, we're still on track for September delivery.
Good to know. The new camera has a dual ISO capability. Mm-hmm. First of all, what is dual ISO? Why do we need something like this?
Okay, so the camera features a dual native ISO architecture. So the camera has a dual native ISO of 400 and 3200. Now, what that breaks down to is two banks of ISO, essentially. So from 100 to 1000 is the first bank of ISO, and from 1250 to 6400 is the second bank of ISO. Now, what happens in the transition between the two, so from 1000 ISO to 1250, is that essentially the log curve resets itself. So at 1250 ISO, you have similar dynamic range in the way that the dynamic range is balanced across the image as you would at 100 ISO. What it allows is, because we're upping in, when we're changing ISO, we're changing in third stop increments, it really enables you to tailor where that log curve is sitting within the scene. And that, for me, is key, because traditionally you would up the ISO by a full stop, but now we've got full control and more parameters for tweaking, which means that you can really get the best out of the camera without having to adversely affect it elsewhere, shall we say. And when that happens, you get a really nice clean shadow area, and you have a really usable image as a result. Couple that with bit depth, and you've really got a powerful item there in terms of what you can push around in post.
While watching those images supplied by Blackmagic, here is some additional information concerning the new camera in no particular order. Blackmagic is promising 13 stops of dynamic range. We are looking forward to testing it in-house. Rolling shutter has not been tested yet. The camera can be charged via the USB connector. While recording to an external media via USB-C connector, the images cannot be captured internally simultaneously. The HDMI output signal supports images in Full HD 10-bit 422 only. ProRes 10-bit extended video mode, retaining greater latitude, is also available with this camera. Photos can be taken with the camera in 4K resolution. Stay tuned to our complete camera review coming soon. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.